Okay guys, welcome back. This is Steeljan here, and now I want to talk to you about future designs as far as having battery packs testing and even the future of where batteries may be going and some things that we can be doing that will move vaping even further towards safety and consistency and standards of manufacturing and all that sort of thing. And my chalk is just so running out. Bigger piece. Okay. I think I am concerned that folks are handling naked batteries. Yes, I said naked in a video where I'm supposed to be being so serious. Naked batteries. We can put a battery in a mod, like putting an IMR battery in a lava tube. It was designed for an IMR battery. Great. It has short circuit protection and everything. So cool. But that battery is going to be coming out of that mod. We're going to be handling the naked battery. An IMR battery, as I explained on another video, can dump mass amounts of amps. If it's short-circuited, it can dump very quickly a bunch of heat and amps. So, what I'd like to propose to the vaping community, if we could come up with some kind of standard, if anybody be interested in doing this, to instead of using naked lithium batteries, if we had somebody design for us a battery pack, and we use this battery pack in our Ecigs that took standalone batteries, and in all kinds of mods, if we want to build mods, a modder could concentrate on the beauty of their mod. This is an Ali. I love this mod. It is so gorgeous. The manufacturing, the workmanship, the beautiful wood. This is an absolutely gorgeous mod. But a person who's really, really good at woodworking may not be, I'm not saying this is, but may not be really, really good at soldering stuff in and choosing mechanical things and stuff. I don't know. I'm kind of making that up. Just, you know what I mean. I hope you do. I'm not trying to slight anybody. Mm-mm, far from it. So what if we had a standardized vaping battery pack? And here's what I was thinking it might look like. It would have inside of it some battery. Some battery. But what would come out of it would be a connector, which would be for power, meaning power to the atomizer connector. A connector that would be for the switch. A connector that would be for on-off. I hope you get the idea on that. Maybe even have an LED. Maybe it would even have charging circuitry so that you can plug in to charge it. And so the battery pack itself would be chargeable. You don't ever have to remove this from your mod until it goes bad. Then you'd just be pulling it out of your mod somehow, however it would open. Like, let's say it fit inside this Ali. You open it and you'd just be undoing a few little connectors, pull it out, put your new one in, do in a few connectors, put your lid on. Of course, you'd have a little charging hole here. And away you go. This way, if we had the battery packs manufactured specifically for vaping, it would not only standardize what we're using and make it safer because it's our design, our global vaping design, but we could demand testing. And I think testing is something that is really scaring me in the vaping world. We, as far as I know of, I don't even see testing. Testing just seems like right now to be, here I made 100 of them and I'll just give them to a bunch of people and see how everybody likes them. See what fails. See what blows up. See what catches on fire. See if the buttons work. So that's my idea for a battery pack. And so when you make a mod, you just solder in the connectors and then you just connect it up. So when you make a mod, you'd concentrate on the beauty of the mod, the aesthetics, how it holds in the hand, that sort of thing, right? Now back when I was designing computer circuit boards, every one of the circuit boards that I designed had to pass what was called four corners testing. And I'd like for us to come up with something for vaping that would be equivalent to four corners testing. But we'd be setting the parameters for what we want to see everything that goes into the vaping community pass. But on computer boards, this is just for your example to give you something to think about. It had to pass low temperature and high voltage. It had to pass low temperature and low voltage. It had to pass high temperature and high voltage, high temperature and low voltage, sorry. And it had to pass high temperature and high volts. Okay, so it had to pass all these four corners of testing, and in this parabolic chamber, perfectly controlled, and then it was stress test for lifetime. So within a few weeks, we had tested that board as if it had performed in the real world throughout its entire lifetime, let's say it's a 10-year lifetime, while it vigorously was exercised with these testing. So we knew that that board passed our level of tests. Okay? Now, so I would like to see, to summarize, I'd like to see two things. I'd like to see a battery pack come out for vaping. It says, this is the battery pack. You plug the connectors into the thing. Modders build your aesthetic pleasure, or what you all want, but it would be our safe battery pack just for vaping. Maybe more than one, different voltages, I don't know. Maybe it regulates watts like the Kick, Evolve Kick is coming out. Anyway, but a battery pack. And that whatever it is, whatever that battery pack is, and actually I'd like to see all mods and all e-cigs that come out on the public, I'd like to see them undergo something like this. Whatever the Ecig version is of four corners testing and lifetime tests in perfectly controlled situations, and I'd like to see some sort of a certification for that. So this last thing I want to talk to you about is the future of batteries. Right now this probably wouldn't be feasible to do because of size restraints, but when we vape at even 3.7 volts, where can I write this? 3.7 volts with a 2.5 ohm cardamizer. I've got my notes written here. That is 1.48 amps. We're demanding 1.48 amps from the battery every time we push the button. Amperage to me is the biggie. What if we stopped having the scary amperages? Amperages now can go 2, 3, 4, even 5 amps. It's getting damn scary, or darn scary. Sorry, it's getting darn scary. I'll cut that out. If we could go to 12 volts, okay, so watts-wise is amps times volts. We have 5.18 amps, or watts, rather. 5.18 watts. What if we could do 12 volts at 5.18 watts? Divide 12 into 5.18, and we'd only have 400 milliamps. Every time you push the button, you'd only be demanding 400 milliamps if we regulate the wattage. And this is where devices like the Darwin from Evolve and the Kick from Evolve come in, regulating the wattage. So look, instead of doing high voltage and just letting it run amok with however many amps the cardamizer atomizer demands, we stick with something where we regulate the watts, and therefore the amps that we need to get the same great vape that we're used to is much, much lower, and we end up with a much, much safer vape. Right now, 12 volt batteries would be pretty huge, but with the future and how battery technology is going right now, who knows? We'll soon know. And my whole idea of doing these videos is because I feel like if we don't, as the vaping community, if we don't self-regulate, this gives the government and other entities more opportunities to come in and say what we can and can't do, what is and isn't going to happen, or shut us down completely with these vape bans. So yeah. So guys, if anybody's interested in doing that, I'm a retired engineer, so I like coming up with ideas. That's about all I know. Still vaping my nickel. metal hydride batteries and my Altoids mod. Till next time, guys, this is Steeljan out. Have a great day, and thanks for watching. Bye. Steeljan.